Hey everybody, Tom with Flash Phones here. We're in the office late tonight. It's myself, my daughter Patty Lee, my youngest, and we're going to show you how to flash the MIFI 2200 to Verizon prepaid without them terminating the data on your account. Now obviously, step one is to use the right donor. We've been saying that for years. I know a lot of you guys who flash have been mad at us because we've always said you got to use the right donor, but it's true. So that's step one. We're going to show you that tonight. Step two is to have the right authentication codes. I can guarantee you that 90% of you guys that are flashing don't have them. We're going to give them to you. There's just too many MIFIs now that are off the network. We can't flash them all. So we're going to give you those codes tonight. We're going to show you how to do it. We're going to make it so easy, 3-month-old could flash. Nah, just kidding. Maybe you might have to be able to read and write first, but so easy that any of you guys who flash now will be able to do it.
Okay, so now we're over at the computer, and I just want to start this guide out by saying that if you're an experienced flasher, this will all make sense to you. If you're not, it's not. Some of it won't make sense to you. This is for the experienced flasher, the guys who have been flashing MIFIs. Verizon just did an update to the security, put new filters on the system, and your MIFIs have come off and you need to flash them back to the system so that you can get these customers out of your shop. This is for you guys. Not the guy who has a MIFI 2200 and wants to flash it to Verizon and save, you know, $60 and not pay somebody who's experienced to flash it for him. Not that this guide won't help you a little bit, but it's primarily for the experienced flasher. So I'm not going into little bits of details on every single little thing. Alright, so I've already set the account up. I set it up with an LG extrovert, which are the only donors we use. I know a lot of you guys have been mad at me because I've advertised for years that we only use real donors, and that's the case, and it's one of the primary reasons why our accounts aren't getting flagged. But the filters are twofold. There are some bypass codes for those filters. We're gonna show you how to set those. But I strongly recommend that you use extroverts as your donors. You shouldn't have any problems. We don't have any issues with ours. Now, I've set that account up, and I've activated the Fascinate to that account. You can see that I have 3G data on the Fascinate. Now we're going to go ahead and read the keys off it. So we'll go ahead and we'll plug that in, and let's go over to DFS. I obviously have Evolution, but you can use the demo. It works just fine, as you probably know. I'm going to go ahead and connect to the Fascinate, and then we'll go ahead and we will send the unlock code. So we'll send that, and we'll go to programming and mobile IP, and we'll read that. And I'm just going to move this over just a little bit. And if you follow the link on CDMA Gurus, if you're watching this on YouTube, the link in the description will take you to CDMA Gurus, and the download link for this Verizon MIFI 2200 folder will be on the forum. So you can double click on this and you're going to see that I have the drivers here. So if you don't have the drivers loaded, there's the drivers. If you have the MIFI 2200 and you plug it in for the first time, it should load the drivers, but if not, I've included the drivers. You're going to see a NAM file and then a programming code worksheet. Let's open that worksheet up. And I've already got it filled out, but I'm going to show you where I get these codes from. Most of you guys should be familiar with this to begin with. But obviously, I have my NAI user ID and then the RMNAI. So you'll put those in there. And then you're going to pull your AAA keys, and you're going to pull your HA keys from DFS, and you're going to put those over here, respectively. Now we're going to move over to the data page, and we're going to read this. And what we want is that PPP password, which is right here. So we're going to take that, we're going to copy it, and we're going to paste it in right here. Now, for this application, what I want to do is I want to get the hex version of that key as well, which is going to be here. A lot of guys will just use the hex version. I don't know why I don't. It's just habit, I guess. I always get both the serial and the hex. But you can just get the hex. It doesn't matter. I'll show you why in a minute. And once you have that, then just go over to NAM and get your MIN. So you can pull that right there and put it in. So once you have all your information, we're going to go ahead and make sure we disconnect from DFS, and we're going to open up CDMA Workshop. Now over in CDMA Workshop, we're going to go ahead and we're going to power up the MIFI, and then we're going to plug it in. We can also go ahead and turn our phone off. So once the MIFI is plugged in, we'll go ahead and connect to the status port. Go to security, send zeros, unlock the device. Then we'll go back to that main tab, and we're going to click on load. And if you navigate back to that Verizon MIFI 2200 folder, that NAM file is going to be there. Just double click on it and load it in. And now we want to scroll over till we get to the EVDO page, and you're going to see that this is set up for you. Obviously, we're going to use the user ID here where it showed with all the zeros. We're going to fill that in. So we'll go ahead and copy that, and we'll paste this in here. Now, the HDRPPP, leave this bypass code in there. Now we're going to go over and we're going to grab the PPP serial and we're going to put it in here. Now, here's the thing. Sometimes these serial codes don't write correctly in CDMA Workshop. However, the hex version will always write correctly. So if you change this from serial to hex, grab this code and put it in here, and then convert it back, it will always write correctly. That's why we grab both. And like I said, a lot of guys just use the hex version. Doesn't matter. Now, I'm going to click on the MIP profiles, and we're going to set both profiles. I know a lot of guys only set one profile. You have to set both of them. As a matter of fact, 0 is going to be our primary profile, and 1 is going to be our secondary profile, which is going to have our bypass information in it. So we're going to grab that username again, and we're going to fill these in. And then on profile 0, we're going to set the AA and the HA keys. Just remember, when you pull them off DFS, AA was on top, HA on the bottom. When you put them in the CDMA Workshop, it's reversed here. And also, remember to switch this from serial to hex before you write them. All right, and then if you go to profile 1, this is going to stay the same. Don't touch those programming codes. Now, you can't see them here, but in the form, these codes are actually going to be listed, so you can copy them and put them right in. All right, so now we're just going to go, before we write it, I'm going to set the MIN and the MDN. You don't have to, but I always do. It's more so I can identify the device in the event of a warranty. And then just write it. Obviously, this is a Verizon device. We're flashing it to Verizon, so we don't need a PRL. So now we'll just pull the battery out of the device. Just wait a minute. Put it back in. Power the device back up. It's back on, so now let's go to our computer and let's see if we can connect. And here you'll see flashedphones.net, which is my MIFI, so we'll double click that and we'll connect to it. And we're connected. Let's see if we can get on the internet. And it looks like we can. So now let's go ahead and go into the device. And I'll just show you, if we go to the Wi-Fi tab, that this is flashphones.net. That's the network name. And if you go to CDMA Gurus, the easiest way to find this post is if you I click on New Posts, and if you scroll down and find Novatel on the right side here, I just click it, and there it is. Flash MIFI 2200 to Verizon and bypass new filters. So I strongly recommend, if you flash phones, that you become a member of CDMA Gurus. You should become a premium member. It's one of the last. Now, I mean, there's several out there that are actual flashing forums, but CDMA Gurus is one of the few places you can go and actually get developer help. Good forum, good guys. You should support it. I recommend it. So that's it. Oh, I did want to show you one more thing. Sorry. If we go back here, we can go to Verizon. I'll go ahead and log into this account just to show you. That we have the LG Extrovert as our donor on this account. So that's it, guys. Remember, we use the LG Extrovert as a donor. We use the programming, both the profiles with the bypass keys. And if you do it this way, you shouldn't have any problems. We have, I don't want to say how many devices, but we have a lot of devices on the network. None of them have been knocked off. We're in day 5 with the new filters. So I think our method is pretty clean. If you have any comments, any questions, please leave them on the forum at CDMA Gurus, and we'll try to answer them there. We will not support answers and questions for flashing the MIFI 2200s on our website over the phone or via our email. It'll all be supported through CDMA Gurus. Thank you very much, guys. And listen, to all you dealers out there who flash and have had issues, a lot of customers coming to your store, we've been flashing almost 8 years. We've seen this in the past. Our hearts go out to you, and we wish you the best. Thanks. Bye.